Hello everybody, this is Ms. Barnacle, and we're going to be talking about multiplying fractions today. And when we do multiplying fractions, there's a cute little saying, and it's kind of helpful to make sure that you understand how to do fractions. And if you look at the screen, it says, when you multiply two fractions together, multiplying fractions is no problem, top times top and bottom times bottom. Now, if you can't remember to reduce first, which sometimes it's easier to reduce first when you have huge fractions that you're dealing with, but when in doubt, you can use this little saying to help you so that no matter what, you know how to do this fraction, multiplying fractions. So we are going to work a few of these on the board. If you look at the first set of fractions, I have 1/3 times 2/5. And what you ask yourself is, okay, 1/3 and 2/5, are they in lowest terms? Yes, they are. And when I talk about reducing fractions, remember you reduce, some people say you cross multiply when you try to see if 1 and 5 can be reduced, and it's not multiplying, you're dividing. So you want to say, do 1 and 5 have anything in common? You know, on the previous lessons, we've been talking about greatest common factor and things like that. If they have nothing in common, obviously you can't reduce that part of your fraction. 2 and 3, they have nothing in common. So when that happens, you have no other choice but to do the little song. Multiplying fractions is no problem. Top times top, so that'd be 1 times 2 is 2. And bottom times bottom, 3 times 5 is 15. And when you can't reduce it, 2 over 15, that is in lowest terms, and that's all you can do to that one. Okay, let's go to the next one. I see 7/8 times 2/3. I'm going to look again and say, okay, do they have anything in common? Can I reduce them in any way? 7 and 3. I don't see anything that I can reduce with them. So I'll look at my other two numbers. I have a 2 and an 8. I do know that 2 divides into 2 and 2 divides into 8. So I can reduce those. 2 divides into 2 one time, so you want to cross that out and put the answer 1. 2 divides into 8 four times, so you want to cross that out and put a 4. Once you've done that, then you do top times top, so that'd be 7 times 1 is 7. Bottom times bottom, 4 times 3 would be 12. And since you reduced it first, that should be in lowest terms. If you went ahead and multiplied across first, you would just have to reduce at the end, which is still okay. Now I look at this. I have 4 and 5 and 35 and 24. If I were to just do top times top and bottom times bottom, I would have a huge number in the denominator, which is why you want to try to reduce first when you can. 4 and 24 have something in common. Their GCF would be 4. So 4 divides into 4 one time. 4 divides into 24 six times. Okay, that made it much smaller. So let's look at 5 and 35. Well, it ends in a 5, so I know 5 goes in there. 5 divides into 5 once. 5 divides into 35 seven times. Once you've reduced everything as low as you can, then you do top times top. 1 times 1 is 1. Bottom times bottom. 7 times 6 is 42. And that's all you can do to that. And then we look at this next one. This last one that I have for us to do in this particular lesson, I know it's got 3, and 3 looks intimidating. But remember this, when you try to reduce a fraction, as long as one digit is at the top and one is at the bottom, it does not matter if they're in the first, second, third, fifth, tenth fraction, however many you've got. So I always start with my first numerator, 3, and I ask myself, look at my bottom numbers. Do any of them have anything in common with a 3 where I can reduce it? Yeah, the 6 way down here does. So 3 divides into 3 once, 3 divides into 6 two times, okay? And then I go to my next fraction, 2. Does 2 have anything in common with anybody? Yeah, it does. 2 has an 8. They both have a 2 in common, so 2 divides into 2 once, 2 divides into 8 4 times. Okay, and then I look at my last numerator, 20. Does 20 have anything in common with any of the bottom numbers? It does. With 5. 5 divides into 5 1 time. 5 divides into 20 4 times. Now, once you've looked at everything one time, go back and look at the answers that you've got now. Can you reduce them any further? Because sometimes you can, sometimes you can't. If I look at the numerators now, I have a 1, and a 4. My denominators are 1, 4, and 2. Well, I see another 4, so I can reduce those as well. 4 divides into 4 once, 4 divides into 4 once. So once you have touched them all one time, go back and see if you can reduce them again. Once you've done everything that you think that you can possibly do, then I do the song, top times top, bottom times bottom. So that'd be 1 times 1 times 1, which gives me 1. And the bottom would be 1 times 1 times 2, which is 2. So when I multiply all of that together, I get the fraction 1/2. Now, if you wanted to multiply all the top together and all the bottom together and then reduce the answer, that's fine. It's just that you're going to want it with a huge number, and sometimes it makes it harder to see when you're doing reducing. All right, that's all I have for us to do today for multiplying fractions. Our next step will be multiplying mixed numbers.